What did you find?
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
We can't trust anybody except each other.
You know more about her than me.
No. You and Chloe think you know more than anybody. Like all teenagers.
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins.
What are you doing in my dorm? You are so fucking dead!
Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims.
What are you doing here, Max?
Victoria has to be next.
What a lame gimmick.
Rachel, why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard. Max, we have to find that spot now.
Your life is in serious danger.
Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done.
Oh God,
Max, look. She's still there.
Oh, no. Chloe. Look how.
What the fuck?
What? Where? The dark room.
Is anybody out there? Please help!
Finally, I'm free. Almost.
Okay, so we're in a pretty bad situation. Victoria's on the ground there.
Victoria, wake up. Wake up.
Nope, she's out of it. Okay, so I've got my legs free. What the hell can I do with my legs? Pull. Can I reach that? I can. sweet. Okay, so we want the photo, right?
I hate looking at myself like that. You'll pay for this, Jefferson.
You know, I'm not actually guilty about getting him suspended. Well, was it suspended? I don't think it was suspended. I think it was just like, he couldn't go on the trip to California. God, can you imagine him on the trip to California? Jesus Christ, I'm glad about that.
God, I don't remember anything that happened. This must be the same drug Nathan used on Kate.
Oh, wait. Use a photo.
I promised I would never go back in time like this again. But this is the only way.
Come on! Focus. That is the wrong way. It's not letting me do it. Do the thing. Aha, there we go.
This angle highlights your purity, see? The slightly unconscious model is often the most open and honest. No vanity or posing, just pure expression. Christ, look at that perfect face. Hold that stare there! Stay still! Oh, Max! You fucked up my shot! But please don't worry. We have all the time in the world. For now, I knew you were special the second I saw your first selfie. Yes, I still hate that word. But I love the purity of your own image. Not like Rachel, who was always looking in the wrong places. Poor Rachel. Wait. Let me try this angle. He tried so hard. But you can't just throw a few subjects around and expect a cohesive style or theme. But he had an eye for shadows, and an eye for a whole lot more. As his elite family will find out, along with Arcadia Bay. Nice. Good. Oh, those eyes. Just too bad you're so goddamn nosy, Max. But this room is under 24/7 surveillance, so all I had to do was text you from Nathan's phone, and you fell right into my hands. You really should have focused on schoolwork, not private detecting with your little friend.
Chloe.
Chloe, right. Yeah, I'm sorry that I killed... that Nathan killed her in self-defense. But she had a troubled history like most Arcadia Bay dropouts. Nobody will be surprised. Or care. Though I promise, people will care when you die tonight, Max. I wasn't lying when I said you have a gift. Okay. Now this looks good. Maybe a few more close-ups. Max, please do not move so much. I need you posed and framed my way. Maybe A new dose will calm you down.
No, no. No.
Now don't move or this will hurt much. Stupid bitch! You just don't listen, do you? In fact, you never did hear much in my class. If you had, you might have seen all this coming. God damn, you are a fighter, though. I've had my eye on you, and I've noticed that you've been more fearless this week than maybe your whole life.
No.
Remember my number one rule. Always take a shot.
Guy's an asshole. I really don't like him. Although I can't imagine anyone really liking him. So he texts us from Nathan's phone.
Oh Jesus! I can't believe that happened. So sick.
Oh. Is she alright? Speak to her.
Victoria. Hey, Victoria. It's Max. Can you hear me?
Max. Oh God. Where are we? Oh, what's happening?
You've been drugged like Kate. And me. Do you remember how you got here?
No, I don't know. Wait, you warned me. You warned me about Nathan. Then I went to Jefferson for help and he was acting so weird. That's the last thing I remember. And I can't move my hands. Help me, Max. Please, I'm sorry for everything.
Listen carefully. Mark Jefferson kidnapped us. He's using Nathan as well. Jefferson is very dangerous, so we have to get out of here before he comes back.
Max, I just can't believe this is real. I don't want to die like this. I'm only 18.
Just hold on, Victoria. Nobody is gonna die anymore.
Max. What's going on? I thought you said Nathan was dangerous, but it was actually Mark? Mr. Jefferson?
I was wrong. I should have known that Nathan couldn't do all this on his own.
Do what? What's going to happen to us? Oh, please get us out of here.
I'm not going to let that asshole get away with this. I need you to be strong. I can't do this alone. We need to act while we're clear-headed. If he toses us again, we'll forget everything.
Then Kate Marsh was telling the truth. Even though I knew she wasn't lying. And I could have helped her, Max. But I hurt her. Now it's my turn.
We're both here, okay?
I just can't believe this is happening. That Jefferson would do this to me. To us.
Victoria, we will find a way to escape. I promise.
Max, I believe you.
Oh, God. This has taken a toll for the worst. Okay, so we're looking at the broken file.
I broke those files when I kicked the trolley.
Yes, you did. Is that convenient in any way?
Wait. Jefferson couldn't handle stains on his photos.
So sorry.
Good. Now I can use them.
I had no clue.
Neither did I. But we do now. I'll find a way out.
Can't use a camera. We want to look at more photos?
Oh. I'm definitely more awake in this photo. I could try this one.
Yeah, do that one. Cool.
This might work. Please work. Thank you.
I'm getting some spectacular images here, Max. Yes, Victoria would kill to be in your place, but she doesn't understand our connection. You're the winner, Max. I choose you, your portrait.
Fuck you.
You're trying too hard. I know you're scared. You all have the same doe-eyed look when you wake up here, replaced by fear as you realize what's about to happen.
Mr. Jefferson, why are you doing this?
Oh, Max, I'm so glad you asked that question. Simply put, I'm obsessed with the idea of capturing that moment innocence evolves into corruption. That shift from black to white to gray and beyond. Most models are cynical. They lose that naivete. However, some Blackwell students carry their hope and optimism with them like an aura, and those lucky few become my models, my subjects.
Yes, you're a psychopath, and this is your last session.
Au contraire, Max. I'm so sane that nobody knows what's happening to you right now. As you can see, Sleeping Beauty here is too harsh for my gentle lens. And don't get me started on your late partner. I had enough of those faux punk sluts in my Seattle days.
You killed Chloe. You murdered my best friend.
She had a loaded weapon. This was clearly self-defense, but that's what happens when you play with guns. Or try to fuck with me. It's better when they don't know. Like pure, sweet Kate.
Blah, blah, blah. God, I hate your voice now.
You might as well savor it, considering it's the last you'll hear. Oh. That struck a nerve. Your face changed color. Beautiful.
You will not get away with this. I want you to know that.
When you told the principal that I made Kate cry, I thought you almost had me. It's good our esteemed Principal Wells is like most administrators, a closet drunk. I do know that the Prescotts are going to have a major scandal when the town finds out what their elite son has been doing for homework.
You used Nathan.
I prefer the term manipulated, like with an image. Nathan's was easy to twist around. I became a sort of father figure for Nathan. It happens often in teacher-student relationships. It was kind of touching for a while.
Did you tell him everything about your plans at Blackwell?
Don't be stupid, Max. I told him what he needed to hear. In return, I had access to the Prescott fortune. Who do you think paid for this glorious darkroom and equipment? How else could I get all these hip new drugs for my subjects?
Rachel Amber was your victim, not your subject.
Oh. Rachel Amber. That's the real tragedy. Nathan thought he could be an artist like me. Instead, the dumbass gave her an overdose.
Why, Rachel?
I don't have time to tell you everything. But she was special. A human chameleon, so many visual possibilities. We had a real connection.
I wonder if you knew Frank. Because how else would you get the drugs, right?
Maybe. Did you know she also had a connection with Frank?
Let's be honest. She was doing the classic bad boy thing. She was over Frank before it began. He just didn't know. Anyway, Rachel is dead. But no tears. Los Angeles would have killed her anyway, so look at this as a favor.
You're evil.
Oh, I see. You're good, because you stopped your friend from beating Nathan up.
I cared more about Nathan than you did.
No, you didn't. It's just too bad that he fell in lust with Rachel. He actually thought he could mimic what I do with the camera and subject, like father, but not like son.
Where is Nathan now?
Dead and buried. After what he did to Rachel, I knew I couldn't keep him as a protege for much longer. Now the police will never find his body. Do you finally get it now, Max? I can't compromise my vision with amateurs.
You are an amateur. Look at the trail of death you left behind. You can't blame all this on Nathan. I don't care what you do to me. You're gonna die, motherfucker. For Chloe and Rachel and everybody else.
I do love your spirit, Max, but you brought yourself here by your own choice. Anyway, I like my models to be seen and not heard. So I have to make sure there's nothing left behind of you. Okay. Now, let's see how these shots came out. I can see why your instant camera is so appealing. You don't need a computer to print your work out.
Alone with a heart.
Hell.
I have all those photos in my diary. This could be a way out.
Oh, now this one.
Oh, wait.
Beam out. I can see why your instant camera is so appealing. Oh. Ah. Okay.
Wait! Please, Mr. Jefferson.
Max, I would love to talk shop, but I really need to go over these pictures. Especially while they're fresh in my mind. I think our session was a career high for me.
Show me the photos in my diary. I thought that one, but then I suppose...
You still have my diary.
Don't worry. Nobody's going to read it. Thanks for reminding me.
Damn it.
There's nothing more innocent than a teenager's diary. Oh, look at your selfies. What a waste of talent. Look at that shot, Max. You can do so much better.
Haha. Very cool, Max. Okay, cool. I was going to ask for the photos so that I could choose. But that actually seems a lot better. So that's like right at the beginning of the game.
I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb
I'm back. For a wonderful photograph. Right back where I started this insane week. And nobody is going to hurt Chloe ever again.
The portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
Who cares? A real visionary, not capturing. Ooh, puns.
I'm not into capturing your interest. That's kind of sick, isn't it?
I guess somebody hasn't had their coffee. Do you want to try again?
Okay, the Daguerrean process. Blah, blah, blah.
And Victoria's turning into a bitch again. Hooray!
Let's move on. Anyway, so the Daguerrean process made portraiture quite popular. Mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you finish reading the assigned chapters.
And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday
time
Heroes.
Time to change time.
The winter to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the
first. Let's make it real easy to capture Mark Jefferson.
And Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Bastard. I have to warn David about Jefferson and the Dark Room.
How the hell do I do that? Oh, nuts. Cell phone.
All I need is David's number, and Jefferson is one text closer to life without parole.
Bag?
I should be able to track down David's number from the school pamphlet. Found you.
Aha. Uh-huh. Sweet. So then I go back and then use the phone. Hopefully I don't have to remember the number because that'd be dumb.
For once, David, I'm praying you'll overreact to this as much as everything else. And take Jefferson down fast. You wanted me to enter the contest, asshole. So maybe I'll be going to San Francisco. And Jefferson, you'll be going to prison.
So I'm actually gonna hand in the photo?
The past within the past. Am I pushing myself too hard?
You're fine, don't worry about it.
It doesn't matter what happens to me. I have to save Chloe.
Mr. Jefferson? We need to talk.
Can you see I'm talking to Mr. Jefferson now?
Yes, I see. But maybe you shouldn't.
And why not?
Hold on, Victoria. Are you okay, Max?
I will be when Victoria understands that hiding behind a screen, posting videos of people, is incredibly cruel and unfair. You're smart enough to know how easy it is to hurt somebody. To destroy their life. I just want you to think about how much it would hurt if somebody did that to you. You can always make the right choice, Victoria. I know you've got a good heart. I've seen it.
Listen, I didn't...
You don't have to explain. There's no reason for you to be so insecure that you can't be happy with your own talent. Wouldn't it be better to lift people up than to bring them down? You could inspire people.
Okay, I don't know what you're talking about now, do I, Mr. Jefferson?
I think I should stay out of this one, Victoria.
Then I guess I'm done talking.
That's okay, too.
It's called that no
that
bullshit.
That was kind of random, Max. What did you mean?
Here's my photograph for the Everyday Heroes contest.
Oh, that was easy.
No. It wasn't easy at all.
Well, I can't prejudge yet, but I'm very happy you decided to enter. That means a lot to me. And Blackwell, the first step for any artist is to put themselves out there in the world without fear. To be innocent.
Or guilty.
Thanks for the photo, and maybe both of us will be jet-setting to San Francisco this Friday.
Or maybe only one of us will be going.
Don't be so modest, Max. Anything can happen in a week.
As you're going to find out, Mr. Jefferson.
Wait, none of that happened? Wait, Kate. Oh, Kate's alive. Holy shit, we changed a lot.
Chloe's alive. Okay, so we're still friends with Chloe. Chloe's still alive. That's good. And Jefferson went to prison.
Whoa! You're okay, Max. You're safe. On a plane.
Wait,
I hope I did everything right this time.
The principal's there? Okay.
Good work, David.
But there's still that slight issue with the storm, right? Like, Chloe knows about it, right?
We're almost in San Francisco. I'm so stressed, but I'm so excited too.
So please don't.
Oh, he's sleeping.
The beginning of the end for Jefferson and the Prescotts.
Kinda glad about that one. Sweet screen.
Aw, I haven't seen Hot Dog Man in forever. Chloe and I used to totally play the video game and watch him all the time. When we were innocent.
Hey. Good job.
I have to admit, I love being called an artist. It's so weird to be in between realities. Everything is out of focus and in the distance.
Please shut off your phone.
Please fasten your seat and stow any electronic gear until the plane is on the ground and at the gate. Thank you. We're starting our descent in a few minutes. It's a beautiful day in San Francisco with clear skies and cool 60 degrees. We hope you enjoyed your trip and we thank you very much for choosing Pacific West Air. Come fly with us anytime.
I don't think so. I'm hoping these airline seats get smaller so I won't have to fly at all anymore.
How did you sleep?
Hope I wasn't snoring out loud, Max.
Just a bit.
It's been a tough week at Blackwell. So I hope you'll forgive me. Between Mr. Jefferson and Prescott's, things have been hectic, to say the least.
I totally get it, Principal Wells.
That's a smart way of telling me to stop whining. We are proud of you for representing Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes Contest. I know I'm not exactly the guy you wanted in San Francisco, but we all want you to have a great experience here.
I already am, and we're not even there. Oh, Christ. Another nosebleed? Max... You're not just screwing around with time.
The hell do we change? What? I thought they did all the photo thingy before we got on the plane. maybe it was something else.
San Francisco is so cool.
And this gallery is huge.
So is the buffet. If an event skimps on the food, you know it's a bad event.
As long as I don't have to eat any caviar.
This is your day, Max. You can do whatever you want. I hope you take advantage of your status and talk to as many influential people here as possible. Work the room.
I don't know. I feel so weird, like I'm a little kid hanging with the adults.
Max, after this week, you are certainly not a little kid anymore. In fact, you're a noteworthy adult being honored by your peers. Now you have to start acting like the photographer you want to be. Hell, I wanted to be in charge of a big school someday. So I started taking charge of things when I was young. Ask my poor classmates. Max, I'm gonna eat up that caviar so you don't have to. Better get in there and start schmoozing. You know, I won't always be here to take charge. But you come talk to me whenever you want.
Come on, Max. After everything that's happened, this should be the least scary thing you've ever done.
No offense. If this was to happen to me, I would also be pretty scared.
You did it. Somehow. I went from the dark room to this gallery. I've been through so many realities in one week. Life is serious cash. Weird.
I thought I was going to say, life is strange. Dude.
Not my style, but the neon is a nice representation. Oh, shit. Pretentious alert.
You can be as pretentious as you'd like to be.
Are you Max Caulfield? Bravo on your entry. I'm the art critic for Iris N magazine, and we would love to include you in a piece about future trendsetters in photography. I'll send you the details this week, if that's okay. Congratulations for your piece.
Cheers, yo. He didn't really look at me when he was talking.
How do these galleries afford to rent here?
There's some pretty cool photos on here, I must admit.
I wonder if I can buy these everyday heroes pictures. Sorry, I don't know your name, but I saw your picture in the gallery brochure, and I just wanted to let you know how cool your entry was.
That is different. Loving the retro vibe.
Oh, no, it's my picture.
Makes me want to go buy an instant camera.
Hi, and there she is to save the day.
Hi. You did it, Max. You're a real artist. At least, for today.
Are you okay? We lost you there for a second.
Your nose.
I'm okay. Jet lag. High altitude. Oh, you left the ringer off, idiot. Oh, come on. Please answer.
Max, holy shit, man, your vision. It's true. You saw the tornado. It's coming.
What? Oh, no. Chloe, where are you?
I'm so fucking scared! I'm by the beach!
Chloe! Can you hear me? Hello? Hello? Oh my god! The tornado was real! Oh, I didn't fix shit! Chloe will die. Arcadia Bay is gonna be destroyed.
Well,
there has to be a way to stop this. For good.
Fuck. Okay, so I don't actually have a clue on this one. Yes, I do. You go to the photo. Oh my god, I'm a genius. Casually walking to the
fucking way. Chloe can't die again.
I have to save her.
Excuse me, I'd love to ask you a few questions about your work.
Sorry, but...
Oh, God damn it. What an asshole, I just had it.
Is breaking apart. What am I doing to time? I just have to make one simple change so I won't end up in San Francisco. Simple.
Oh, we're gonna tear it up. Oh, okay.
Sorry, San Francisco. Chloe comes first. Here again? I thought I fixed everything.
What did you say, Max?
What? Jefferson should be in jail, not here.
Jesus. It's like you're back in my class. You're still spacing out. It might be cool if you took one of your patented selfies now. The transformation between the old Max and the new Max. Anyway, answer my question, please.
Eat shit and die, or fuck you. I like this one better.
Eat shit and die.
Good answer. Good answer. Hey, your nose is bleeding. Probably gave you too big a dose. Sorry about that, Max. But considering you're about to die, a nosebleed is a first world problem. Oh. I had to let Victoria Chase go.
You let her?
Don't be stupid, okay? She's exactly where she deserves to be.
No.
Oh, as if you care.
He killed her?
Your iris, that dilation like a shutter. The pictures you're taking of me now. Too bad you pissed away your gift. You could have won the contest, but you destroyed your own beautiful photograph. What a waste. Sorry, I burned all your stuff. I got a little carried away.
Fuck! He burned my diary.
Always.
That's why I'm still here.
Especially since you've developed from nerd to hero within a week. There's something weird going on with you. Whoa. Did you see how crazy it is outside? Like I said, something weird. There's that fear. Oh, Max, it's an honor working with you on these final sessions. I hope these images will be appreciated for what they truly capture. The loss of youth. At least, that's the last lecture you'll ever have to hear from me. And I promise you, no more nosebleeds.
Mr. Jefferson, please, don't do this. You don't know what's happening.
Shh, 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 shh. Quiet.
quiet, Max.
That son of a bitch.
Please! Don't do this!
Oh, no, I promise, son of a bitch.
This final dose won't hurt.
I think if he drugs me, that's like the end. Fuck.
I promise. This final dose won't hurt.
Fuck. I'm fucked, aren't I?
What?
Wait,
Jesus! David Madsen! He's out cold. Good. I always hated that fascist fuck. Everybody at Blackwell did, right, Max? Okay. Let's try this one last time.
I have to wait. Yeah. So you have to.
I could rewind all the way. I talk to Jefferson, it helps set a trap.
So the way the game like works is that you have to go through that whole scene, I think, so until you change it.
I could rewind all the way. I talk to Jefferson and help set a trap.
No, the game.
I could rewind all the way. I talk to Jefferson and help set.
I can't stretch time anymore.
I could rewind all the way. I talk to Jefferson and help set a trap.
I think I've broken the game.
I talk to Jefferson and help set a trap.
I've broken the game. But it's a perfect time to finish right there. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll sort this out till next episode.